It was colder than a witch's tit in a brass bra that night as I fought my way past his loyal compadres to the very same saloon we're sitting in today. Look around and imagine this place painted in blood. Harden was waiting for me, and... Wait, I'm jumping the gun here. Let me back up and give you some background on this sumbitch. He deserves that much. Don't you think so, Ben? John Wesley Harden was a killer. By the end, he confessed to taking the lives of 42 men. Fathers and husbands, brothers and sons, men with families who cared about them. Families who put up money in hopes of finding justice. He was a bona fide folk hero by then, and had amassed a gang of armed miscreants and other assorted thugs. He and his men set up camp outside of town, and I was hoping Bob was among them.
Shit, it's cold out here. Freezing my giblets off.
See if I can.
Ain't right,
this
we gotta
out.
Stay out here keeping wise on this. Ain't no worse to.
God damn it!
Son of a bitch!
Yeah.
They didn't ask why I was there. They knew. Most of them were wanted as well. I had to spill a lot of blood to find out Harden wasn't in that camp. He was carousing in town with his closest friends. Harden's boys apparently didn't want me to reach the bull's head. Some were hightailing it into town to inform their jefe of my unwelcome presence.
Oh, shit.
Tell Harden someone's coming for him!
Stop that, sumbitch!
All right, where are ya?
Let the boys know we got another law dog.
That's right.
Run! Whatever.
I'm gonna shoot you!
I wondered if Bob was among them. And I steeled myself for the fight ahead. For as good as I was, deep down I wondered if John Wesley wasn't just a little bit better. Before I could test my mettle against Harden, however, I would first need to dispatch his cadre of hired killers. Most of these degenerates were beyond redemption, but John Wesley might have been a different story. I didn't learn until later that that night was in fact his birthday celebration.
Oh, can't get a good shot in.
I think I already mentioned that I found Harden in this very saloon. Suffice it to say, nobody there was happy to see me. In fact, I felt a certain hostility. I was disappointed that neither Bob nor John Wesley were among the dead. But that was short-lived, as a moment later I was facing down the fastest gun in the West. I felt a bolt of adrenaline. Or maybe that was fear. He was well known for his tricks, and I knew I'd need my own if I was ever to defeat him.
Okay, thing is, he definitely is faster than us. But there's another point to this main game where we have to dodge bullets. Oh shit. I think I fucked up.
That man was faster than grease lightning. But being inebriated as he was, he didn't count his shots. And now, he was at my mercy.
So he didn't die?
No, I sent him to prison. Years later, after he was free, some restless avenger took his life. Shot him in the back in a saloon just like this one. Anybody up for another beer? Ben? Thank you, darling. Yeah, some say revenge is a dish best served cold.
So whatever happened to that Bob guy you were after?
Personally, I'd like to hear some of your other adventures. Like, I don't know, do you ever go toe-to-toe with a red man?
Yes, I did, Ben. I remember once I was after this renegade Apache, Grey Wolf. Strangely enough, revenge was also his primary motivation. A bounty was put on Grey Wolf's head, and that's how I came to hunt him in the mountains. Mountains so high, they tickled the nether regions of heaven.
All right.
Grey Wolf was a Chiricahua Apache medicine man who had led a war party in revenge for a massacre against his people. The U.S. Army had attacked his tribe during his daughter's sacred sunrise ceremony, and the slaughter was unspeakable. I understood his anger, as there's nothing more traumatic than seeing those you love die in a cruel and painful death. Right from the beginning, I couldn't shake the feeling that Grey Wolf was watching my every move. He led a band of young Apache warriors who wanted retribution and were more than willing to die for him.
Let's take the bridge.
They saw me before I saw them.
This usually is the case.
And it crossed my mind that maybe this wasn't such a good idea. But now that the shooting had started, there was no backing down.
I'm good with my god. Right in the ass.
It was rugged country. The winter home of the Chiricahuas. And that's why they had retreated there.
It's blended into their... I swear, all the enemies in this game blend into their environments.
I admit to having some regrets about going after them the way I did. But then again, I got a lot of those. Not at that moment, but I did find the entrance to their hideout. Deep crevice that led to a deeper cave.
Don't tell me you went in there.
Yeah, but it's not out of bravery so much as pure, angry cussedness. See, back then, I had a stubborn streak a mile wide, and I wasn't about to back down.
So it was like pitch black in there?
Actually, it was pretty well lit, as they had torches on the wall. Was his cave? Big as hell, Ben. But Chiricahua had hit out there during the Indian War. They thought it was haunted with the ghosts of those murdered by the horse soldiers.
The cave was haunted with dead Indian ghosts?
To be honest, I was more concerned with the live ones than the dead ones.
You know so much about engines.
A few years back, I was married to two Mescalero women.
At the same time?
Yeah, they were sisters. Polygyny is traditional among the Mescalero.
So what happened?
I had to get out of there. Those girls never shut up. Both of them nagging at me all the time. Drove me half crazy. Haven't seen them since.
No, I mean, what happened with Grey Wolf?
Oh, well, I pursued him into the Cave of Death.
Nice name.
I came upon this flooded grotto, and that's when I saw him. He came to me unarmed and unafraid. His voice echoed in the shadows, and I sensed he meant me no harm.
You carry great darkness in your heart. And if you do not release it, it will claim your soul.
The sound of his voice put some kind of ancient Indian spell on me. As his story unfolded in my mind.
You will come to this place again, and kill many more men, and the darkness will grow until it consumes everything that you are.
He said I was a great warrior, a coyote man, unequaled by any other pale-faced warrior, or something like that.
The snake snakes will bite shadows of your past until the pain poisons your heart, and an echo of the song of the dead summons the spirits deep from within the mountains.
I didn't quite get what he was saying, but there was definitely snakes. And indeed, his warriors surrounded me and attacked me like hungry wolverines. They couldn't stop me, though, and Grey Wolf wasn't in the mood for idle talk.
I might as well max out, Trapper. I don't think I'm going to use it, but why the hell not?
I swear I couldn't see any way out of this trap. But suddenly, one just appeared. Kinda like a miracle.
Guess
I felt like I would be lost in that damn cave forever. Finally, I found myself back outside, perched on the edge of a precipice, overlooking a thundering whitewater river.
Shit, I dodged the wrong way. There we go. Done.
I chased after him, determined to make him explain the meaning of all that mumbo jumbo.
Mumbo jumbo is right. Are you making this all up as you go?
A few details may be fuzzy, brother, but I am relating exactly what happened to me. There were dozens of Apache warriors aiming at me from on high.
Dozens?
Well, maybe not dozens, but there was a lot of them.
At least three or four.
Well, more than that, little lady.
Hopping.
I had a steep climb up creek ahead of me and scrambled up those rocks like a mountain. I was determined to locate Grey Wolf and find out exactly what the hell he was trying to tell me. And wouldn't you know it, that crafty son of a bitch led me right into a
trap.
Well, son, there had to be at least 100 Apaches surrounding me.
100?
God be my witness.
Oh, come on. Who are you kidding?
Hey, I believe you. Come on, tell us how it ended.
All right, but I'm not gonna drag this out. Where were we?
You were surrounded by 100 Apache warriors.
All right. And there we go. We fully unlocked the Trapper. Now, we can concentrate on the Gunslinger.
Well, I didn't take the time to count them exactly. But there were a lot of them.
Yeah.
and in the end, a path appeared before me that I had not seen before.
How could you miss that?
I followed it, as I desperately needed to find out what Grey Wolf was trying to tell me. But it was like that son of a bitch disappeared into thin air.
Cool.
Never did find him. And never did collect my goddamn bounty.
Oh, I don't have any more points. Alright.
Thank you, darling. It's interesting how the truth can sometimes seem, might malleable, depending upon your point of view.
Like how those dime novels make you out to be something you're not?
Jack, don't be starting trouble.
No, he's right. They do tend to exaggerate.
Did they exaggerate your part in taking down the Daltons?
Well, I was there in the flesh, boy, so I saw what happened firsthand. Those Daltons were lawmen once, before they all went bad, robbing banks and trains clear across the territory. Until Coffeyville, of course. I was one of the citizens who took up arms that day.
Fighting on the side of the right?
I did my best, sir. We all did. It was early morning. One of my friends was a local gunsmith, and he handed out firearms to anybody who'd take one. You see, the Daltons got it in their heads to rob two banks at the same time. Two banks on the same damn street. Story was Bob Dalton's girl was always riding him about how he had no ambition. Well, the locals recognized the Daltons right off. Before they could get away, half the town took up arms to defend their property.
Let's do this!
The brothers paid dearly for their stupidity, but everybody knows they had it coming.
There's more to it than that. I read all about that day, so I know for a fact that it went down very differently. First of all, it was high noon. A posse of U.S. deputy marshals were on the rooftop across the street.
Get ready, boys. They're gonna make a move.
The lawmen had been tracking the Daltons for months. Now they finally had them dead to rights. Among them was a bounty hunter feared by many a lawbreaker. This man had no intention of letting the Daltons slip away. The marshals tried to get the Daltons to surrender.
They'll give up eventually. We just gotta put these son of bitches out.
This bounty hunter knew that the brothers were far too proud to ever lay down their guns. He went in there alone to confront those criminals. One of the marshals shouted, "Where are you going? Are you crazy?"
"Hey, where do you think you're going, dumbass? That rifle's mine."
But he paid him no mind. He saw a way to get around to the back of the bank. Then he figured out how to hit the Daltons from a direction they weren't expecting. A moment later, he was climbing up a steep ladder, laughing at danger as he did. Brave men like him who risked their lives to tame this wild country.
We've got company!
Heroic men like him, who did what other men couldn't or wouldn't to make this country free.
Is that Silas Green?
Jim Booth!
Son of a bitch!
Died defending the Alamo. came away victorious, taking down those thieving Daltons.
Like a boss.
His name was Silas Greaves, and when the dust finally settled, he was the last man standing.
Sorry, kid, but that just wasn't the way it happened.
Enough time for Silas's version.
It was early evening, not high noon.
Shoot him!
Daltons blew up a safe, and were all set to hightail it out of there. I was late to the party, and Coffeeville was already up in arms. Those pathetic deputies surrounding the bank were dropping like flies. I'd been tracking those jokers for months, waiting for them to do something reckless. And finally, they did. Those stupid bastards decided to rob two banks at the same time in the same town where everybody knew them, but they still had friends in Coffeeville.
You gonna need a cannon! Shoot him!
Those friends came after me like a pack of wild dogs, tooth and nail. They were coming at me from all directions. I caught sight of the Daltons running with the money and didn't want to lose it. Problem was, they knew the town better than I did. To top it off, I found myself in the middle of another shootout entirely.
Did the Daltons hold up in somebody's house?
No, it was the Smiths, I believe. They were cousins of the Daltons. They were shooting at the Browns, who were shooting at the Daltons. Which wasn't any surprise, because those two families have been feuding forever. And since the Joneses are related to the Browns, they shot at the Smiths, pissing off the Heimhoffers, whose daughter recently married a Smith. Well, bullets were flying every which way as all the old feuds in Kansas caught fire all at once. There was a hell of a lot of pissed off people in Coffeeville that day. But that's just the way life is sometimes. Shit happens. The Dalton boys knew I would never give up. Those Daltons weren't the sharpest knives in the drawer, but they always stood together. They set a trap to slow me down and allow at least two of them to escape. The third brother stayed behind to plant me, just in case that trap of theirs didn't work. It was Emmett, the youngest, and he decided to stand his ground and face me down.
I ain't afraid of you, Silas Greaves. This is where it ends for you.
He was determined to protect his brothers. And I understood how he felt. Taking me on all by his lonesome wasn't exactly a recipe for a long time.
Yeah, law dog!
I have to admit, this guy is really damn hard
to
kill.
It's all killing time.
Survived the robbery in Coffeeville. He's the only Dalton who did.
They say he was shot 23 times.
Well, Dwight, who do you think put all those damn holes in him?
I think it was more than 23.
But I have to admit, That boy had grit.
We'll get those suckers!
It took me a couple of days to track the Daltons down.
They can't get away with this!
And in that time, a whole posse of local vigilantes offered to lend a hand.
We'll track them to the ends of the earth.
They seemed as determined as me to find those outlaws. But as we headed into those swamps, it was like I had my own private army. There was no way those boys were getting away this time.
All right, I'm gonna leave it off here until I feel like finishing this off. This isn't a very long game, by the way. My first time playing it, I finished it in about 6 hours. So I'm just gonna leave it off here for now, and try to edit these down and upload them. So until next time.